This Harlan Game Wrap is presented by the Hawks Pride Sports Association. This game recap is brought to you by IBC Bank, We Do More. And by Greg Sherman Videography. Call 419-902-3353 for all your video needs in San Antonio and the Hill Country.
The final day of the high school football regular season brings with it a little bit of history and a district title game as San Antonio Harlan plays host to Laredo Martin. Harlan is 9-0 on the season. They have a chance to become the first ever second-year varsity program in San Antonio football history to go a perfect 10-0 in their sophomore year. This game also has a lot of district implications. The winner of this game will take the 14-5A district title and the number one seed that goes with it, as well as a first-round matchup against the winner of Burbank and Lanier. This game also has a lot of implications for San Antonio Southwest. They beat Eagle Pass Wind last night. Should Martin lose, Southwest would move up to the number two spot. Who would take the 14-5A Division I district title? Well, let's check out the highlights here at Gustafson Stadium.
Harlan was the favorite, but the game was expected to be close for at least a little while. Little while was a relative term. Martin won the toss, took the ball, but on their third play of the game, the Tigers fumbled the handoff. It was recovered by Manuel Leon, and the Hawks quickly were in business. Martin still had a chance to make a defensive stop on the ensuing drive. 4th and 4, Harlan at the Tiger 22. Head coach Eddie Salas passed on the field goal. Quarterback Cannon Williams hit at the line, but bounced off two defenders to pick up 5 yards and the first down. From that moment on, nothing went right for Martin, and everything did for Harlan. 2 plays later, Williams play action, ran left, bounced off another defender, and scored from 16 yards out. 7-0 Harlan, and for all intents and purposes, the competitive phase of the game was over. Later in the quarter, offensive line blocking was absolutely perfect. Aubrey McDade ran through the line, bounced off 2 defenders, said hello to umpire Jonathan Sunday, and ended up with a 16-yard gain. That led to a field goal, 10-0 Hawks. 2nd quarter, after a defensive stop on 4th down, Williams found Kamali Anderson 27 yards down to the Martin 3. It led to a McDade touchdown run, 17-0.
We come out strong. We come out prepared to block. We work hard every week. I mean, we just work every day, every week, put in the work and put in the time, put in the effort, and we just come out strong.
Things only got worse for the Tigers. Tigers faced a 4th and 11 at the Harlan 41. Cham faced the turf. That's because sophomore David Meyer broke through the line and sacked the sophomore quarterback. Another turnover on downs forced. Ensuing drive down to the 13, Williams threw the non-circular object to the corner of the end zone. Conveniently, Andreas Spriggs was there for the catch and the toe tap in the end zone. 24-0, the 2nd of 3 touchdowns Harlan scored following 4th down stops. Next Martin drive, Cham threw the ball into triple coverage. Easy interception by Ja'Cory Logan. He caught the wedding bouquet. Spriggs caught the ring. I mean the deep slant from Williams 40 yards out for the score. He finished the game with only 3 catches, but all 3 were for touchdowns. Those flag runners probably had to hit the ice bath after the game, as they did a lot of running. Fans, though, sat back and enjoyed the 31-0 lead at halftime. Harlan had 4 touchdowns, while Martin had 3 first downs.
We just came out ready. We wanted the district championship really bad, and we're going to do anything that we can to get it. Greatest offensive line in the city.
We just came focused. We came ready. We wasn't scared. We just came and we trusted our rules. We came to play, and we just did our job.
3rd quarter was about the same as the first 2. Cham passed into double coverage, short, picked off by Zane Svoboda. That led to the final Spriggs touchdown, 41-0. Backups started getting into the game, and Martin, well, they couldn't stop them either. Yamani Massey, 70 yards on this touchdown run. The Hawks ended up with 337 on the ground and 507 total. The Tigers did score a slew of pity time touchdowns, but they were nothing more than cosmetic. The game was all roses for Harlan. 30 months ago, the program didn't exist. Now they are a district champion and the first second-year program in area history to go 10-0 with a dominating 48-21 win. Eddie Salas took an ice bath after the game. The players, though, were nice enough that they even helped clean up the field afterwards. Maybe they gave some of that ice to those flag runners. Salas addressed his team afterwards.
We've been playing for Shamari and for the memory and for his family and for Kamali. Now I'm going to tell you today, today we honored them. Yes, we honored everything. Our goals have been set. Everything else from now on is just the next step. It's just the next thing. But this day and today was about him.
They also tied Brandeis' record for the most wins in the first 2 years of an area football program with 18. Up first in the playoffs will be Burbank out of SAISD. The Bulldogs scored 2 touchdowns in the final minutes to beat Lanier 28-27. The Vokes missed a PAT after a pick six early in the fourth, which turned out to be the difference. That game against Burbank will be Friday night back at Gustafson Stadium. Reporting from San Antonio, I'm Greg Sherman.